ETH 2.0 is bullish for the market, right? Right? Well, the market is saying a different story right now. So I want to go and break down a couple things going on with Ethereum, ETH 2.0, and what this means for the future of ETH. If you guys are ready to go ahead and get started trading with this coin, there's a link in the description below so you guys can get 20% off trading fees, as well as the chance to earn $500 in free USDT. As you guys can see here, the chart is looking pretty negative. It's not looking saucy, and you're probably thinking to yourself, what is going on? Well, there's several different factors going on right now. This is one of our last support lines, is going to be around the 1300 mark. We're bouncing around the $1,500 support line, around 1,000, just because it's a psychological number. That should be another support as well. But there isn't a lot of buys and sells around that area. I think more so psychologically, that will be a support line. But specifically, the reason why Ethereum is doing what it's doing has to do with several different things. The very first has to do with the external market conditions. As you guys can see, a lot of people are risk off right now. Interest rates are going up, free money from the government and stimulus checks are not going out as easily, and you also have further fears of recession. These are contributing factors for the market in general as a whole, as well as overvaluations in the crypto market as well as the stock market. So going specifically on the ETH token and the Ethereum network, one of the things I want to point out has to do with overvaluation. I'll get later into ETH 2.0 and some potential negative things that could be coming for it. But the first thing I want to go over is the overvaluation of ETH. And I want to give you guys the first tweet to go over. This is from Andrew Kang. He's over Mechanism Capital. It's a VC fund. But Andrew Kang is someone who is very knowledgeable in the space. He's making this statement: most ETH merge valuation models drastically overestimate earnings. The same happens in equity bull markets. Think bear markets, net earnings for ETH to get to $500 million to $1 billion annualized. So even at $300 ETH, a $40 billion market cap, which is what it would be at $300 a pop, this means it would still be sitting on a high earnings multiple. Because if you factor it in, if it's only earning $500 to $1 billion, that's sitting at between a 40 to 80 times PE ratio. Currently, it's way more than that. And for normal companies, it's going to be around 30 or less. That would be the norm. Now, I'm not calling Ethereum a company. It's a little bit different animal, but this is just putting things into perspective. It's massively overvalued right now if you denominate it in dollar terms. The reason why it's overvalued is the potential and the technology that Ethereum provides. But there is a reflexivity aspect to this. If the ETH dollar value is going down, its earnings is also going down. Let's say, for example, every day 10 Ethereum is burned. So 10 ETH, and ETH is worth $2,000. That means the revenue for that day would be $20,000. But if ETH goes to $1,000 and 10 ETH is burned, our revenue is now only $10,000. So with the reflexivity of ETH, not only is the network activity going down in a bear market, aka burning less ETH, also the dollar value in ETH is going down. So you're spending less ETH and the dollar value of ETH is less. So you're earning less in dollar terms. Now some will say one ETH is always one ETH and dollars are junk. Well, I get it. But the dollar is the reserve currency of the world, so it always has demand. This is why things are measured in the dollar. Lastly, I want to mention this. Always, all the time, this happens. Things are overvalued in a bull market. Think the dot-com bubble. If you had dot-com on your name, automatically 50x your valuation. So if you're worth $1 million and you're like pets.com, you're now worth $50 million. That's just how the dot-com bubble was, and it's the same thing with crypto. Add blockchain, boom, pap, what the snap, you're saucy. So now let's go over to ETH 2.0 and a couple of things that we should think about of whether it's really bullish or if it's going to be bearish for Ethereum. Ethereum right now is taking a beating with the external market circumstances, as well as a little bit of FUD around fear, uncertainty, and doubt is what FUD stands for, about ETH being a security and with ETH and the 2.0 coming up and not working out. So here is the curve STETH to ETH pool. STETH is your Lido staked ETH. This is just showing you what the market currently thinks of staked ETH and the confidence it has in it. If I had 1,000 staked ETH, I would automatically only get 963 ETH. There's a huge arbitrage difference, over 3.5% arbitrage difference. STETH is the liquid staked Ethereum, and it's selling at a discount compared to ETH. This is just a representation of what the market currently thinks of ETH 2.0. In theory, these should be 1-to-1 because this is ETH 2.0 ETH and this is ETH 1.0. Of course, it shouldn't be 1-to-1 exactly because you have opportunity costs, but still, it should be much closer than it is now if there was extreme confidence in the ETH 2.0. Second is you have rumors of ETH a security or not. Now, some people are like, ETH is a security, some is not. And Gary Gensler, head over SEC, hasn't really mentioned and said, ETH is not a security. He hasn't said it was a security. He hasn't said it wasn't a security. There is no stance on it. So it looks like they're still determining this. Now, when it moves from proof of work to proof of stake, you now have a function that almost deems it as a security. Because typically when someone gets Ethereum, they look to seek profit and revenue by staking it, which has definitions of being a security. Now, of course, there's other arguments for being the utility. It's adding security to the network, but I'm just giving both sides of the argument right now. Another thing to mention is the centralization of some of the validators for ETH 2.0. If we go onto the ethereum.org staking page, you can see here there's a total of 13.4 million Ethereum staked. Now you see 400,000 validators and you're like, this is good, this is good. And I'm like, yeah, I agree. But one of the largest validators is Lido. If you go on Lido and see STETH, they have 4.2 million of the staked ETH. That's a large percentage for a proof of stake network. And this is concerning. The reason this is concerning is because a lot of Ethereum and a lot of the network strength is with one entity. And the one entity that governs over ETH is anyone who is a Lido token holder. So in theory, you're as strong as your weakest link. If someone wanted to gain the system and grab a large market share of ETH, they would just need to have a large portion of the Lido network. Now there are other solutions coming out like Rocket Pool that allow a more decentralized option. But the reason why different services like this are coming out is because in order to stake ETH and run your own node, you have to have 32 ETH. This is expensive for some people and it prices some people out. It's both a good and bad thing. Typically, someone who's serious, they will get the 32 ETH and they will run their node seriously, which is good for the network. Of course, you also have the factor of if you have 32 ETH, it's a high barrier to entry for retail. So less decentralization. Now, the last thing I want to go over for ETH is the speed of rolling out ETH 2.0. As you can see here, ETH dominance is a little over 55% of the total realm of TVL in DeFi. Whereas before, it was over 95%. It had most of the market share. Being that ETH 2.0 is taking time to come out, other layer ones and alternative solutions are actually gaining a market share, grabbing TVL and getting a community. When this happens, this is actually draining liquidity from Ethereum. And if you think about it, this does affect the ETH price because most of the DeFi pools, they're either paired with ETH, wrapped ETH, or you have people using the network and burning Ethereum. If they're bringing their money onto other chains, that's less network activity on Ethereum, which is less income and revenue. And then there's also less ETH being locked up into these pools. So you have less demand for Ethereum. If you have more supply, less demand, this causes these price fluctuations. And the reason why ETH 2.0 coming out and being delayed is bearish on Ethereum is because the gas fees are a concern. It's very expensive to move back and forth and submit transactions on Ethereum network, and it's much cheaper on others. It's also very slow compared to other chains. So until ETH 2.0 comes, other people may be looking for other solutions. So overall, what are my closing thoughts on Ethereum and ETH 2.0 for the price? Well, the first is, due to external market circumstances, it's going to have an effect on ETH and other assets due to the overvaluation that was from the bull market. Second is that they're earning less money now. And this is just due to the bear market and reflexivity of crypto and the Ethereum market in general. Now, as for ETH 2.0, there is some uncertainty around it, and you can see it in the market confidence based on the STETH and the ETH swap pairs. You can see that a lot of people are uncertain about it, and you have it trading at a discount right now. Also, the other bearish aspect is that, well, people are looking for alternative solutions and looking for a cheaper, faster, better solution than the current ETH version that we have now. And of course, we'll go ahead and talk about the elephant in the room. When ETH 2.0 comes, the people who delegated on Ethereum, like in Lido and for staked ETH, they may want to take profits. So when they take profits, they sell. It's typically not good for the ETH price. When you press red button, it means the number go down. Let's go ahead and leave you guys with a wisdom one-liner. Proverbs chapter 14, verses 6. The mocker seeks wisdom and finds none, but knowledge comes easily to the discerning. Look for knowledge, be discerning. Thanks for watching this KuCoin DigiDive. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you like, subscribe. Tell me what you guys think of ETH 2.0. And if you want to see some of our previous videos, there's one here, 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 and like there. We'll see you guys in the next one.